Welcome you all for the subject Energy Resources and Utilization. Subject code is 14E540, and in this short video with respect to the course objective CO5, and course objective 5 is explain the basic principles and technologies of various renewable energy resources based power generation. In this we are going to discuss about a part of hydroelectric power plant topics, and particularly this short video is released as a flipped classroom activity in order to effectively utilize the classroom time for problem solving and discussion. In this short video we are going to see the very short recap of what are the things we already discussed in the hydroelectric power plant, and then we will discuss about the mass curve in this video itself, and possibly we will see how we can select the site for the site selection, right? So now we will see the short recap, and these are the things we already discussed. That means we already discussed introduction for the hydroelectric power plant and hydrology, hydrographs and flow duration curve. Now we are going to start with the mass curve. So in detail, these are the slides we already discussed, and just take a glance on all those things whatever we discussed here. So we discussed about what is hydrology, water cycle, stream flow, hydrographs and sample hydrographs, flow duration curve. We took a small example to understand the flow duration curve, and this is what the hydrograph we draw in the class, and this is the flow duration curve. So now it is the time to start the mass curve. So the mass curve, before starting the mass curve, intention of drawing the mass curve is to retrieve the two different data. One is what are the size of the capacity of the reservoir you can expect out of a particular stream of water flow. That is the first data. And second thing is, after constructing a dam, how much water you can retrieve for your own purpose, maybe an irrigation purpose or maybe an power production purpose, how much rate of water flow you can expect out of the reservoir constructed based on your recommendation. So that is two things you can understand and two things you can retrieve. So here the plot is between the cumulative volume of water and the x-axis may be a time in the way of days, weeks or months. And the cumulative volume of water can be represented with meter cube or the day second meter or the acre foot. Usually we will represent with the day second meter unit. And what is mean by the day second meter is, suppose you are receiving a flow rate of 1 m³/s throughout the day and throughout the 7 days, then you will get this much amount of water. That means 60 multiplied by 60 for 24 hours, you get this much amount of water, meter cube of water, and this is the cumulative water you get out of this much amount of flow rate for 24 hours. So now this will be equivalent to 1 day second meter. Similarly, the acre foot is equivalent to 1233.48 m³, and this is what with respect to the preliminary data you need to familiarize on the mass curve. Now we will go for a small example to understand how to draw the mass curve and how we can calculate the two different parameters. So here you take this example. This is the data for a weekly flow at a particular sample site, right? And here the data given us in this table. And first week, the meaning of this is 6000 m³/s of water, an average flow you are expecting on the throughout the 7 days of the first week. Similarly, during the second week, you are getting this much amount of meter cube per second of flow rate you are getting as an average throughout the second 7 days. Similarly, the next 7 days this much, and the very next second this fourth week this much, and similarly till the 12th week you will get the various flow rate out of the river, or it may be a channel of water on a particular site. Now with this data you are going to draw the mass curve, and also you are going to calculate what is the size of reservoir you can construct across this water source, and similarly you can calculate what is the possible flow rate you can expect out of this reservoir. Supposed to be a reservoir you are going to construct, and out of the reservoir how much water flow rate you can expect, and these three things we are going to do in this forthcoming slides. And assume that the site is suitable for building the dam necessary to provide the storage in the reservoir. This is just an assumption. And now you take the example. To find the mass curve, first thing you need to calculate it. You need to calculate the cumulative value of water that can be stored week after week, must be formed. So how this can be found is with this simple example you can understand. You make it four columns, and with respect to the number of weeks you make the rows, and the first row represents on the first week you are getting this much amount of water flow rate, and this water flow rate is exist for first 7 days, that is the meaning of 1 week. And now you multiply the 6000 by 7 days, you will get this much amount of day second meter. It's a weekly value you are expecting out of your proposed water site or water channel. And now at the end of the 7th day, and you will get this much amount of day second meter amount of cumulative water you can store on the your proposed reservoir site. Similarly, and the second week this much amount of flow rate you are getting, and this much amount of water you can expect on the second week alone, in along with the first week, by adding these two things, it is 42,000 plus 35,000, you get 77,000 day second meter on the end of the second week. Similarly, you can calculate the remaining week cumulative water flow or cumulative water capacity you can store on the proposed reservoir. So similarly, at the end of the 12th week, you can expect this much amount of day second meter as a storage water on the your proposed reservoir. Now, this is the preliminary data required to draw the mass curve. Now, with this data, you prepare an y-axis for a volume of water in the day second meter unit. You prepare a x-axis on the number of weeks, and for a first week there is no water flow as per your data, zero. And on the first week you are getting, at the end of the first week you are getting 42,000 day second meters. Similarly, at the end of the second week you are getting around 77,000 day second meter cube, that you can visualize here. The end of the first week 42,000, end of the second week 77,000, and similarly at the end of the seventh week 1,36,500 day second meter cube. So here at the end of the second week you can get some 1 lakh something of water flow. And similarly, you need to plot all the 12 weeks data. So now this complete graph will be called with the name of mass curve, right? So now with this mass curve, how we can retrieve the data means we need to do some small modifications. So here you identify the points where your inflation start on the mass curve. So this may be a possible point A, you can consider as the starting point for the inflection or inflation. And here, this is the ending point of the inflection, B. So now you draw a tangent line between the A and B. Now, you find the slope for the Now you find the slope for the tangent line, maybe possibly you can call it as AB line. You try for that. Now yourself calculate the slope of the line AB. For that I draw a line here and this line. Now this height you can calculate from this axis, and this can be projected to this x-axis, and you can find what is the slope, and possibly the slope may be around 3000 something meter cube per second. Now what it means is, out of the expected reservoir you can get around 3000 something meter cube per second of water continuously for withdrawal. Suppose you are installing a turbine for a power plant, means the power plant or turbine can be sized or can be designed for 3000 something meter cube per second. That is, the slope of this AB line will decide the withdrawal quantity of, or withdrawal flow rate of water out of the expected reservoir. That is the first data. And second, we need to decide what is the size of the reservoir we need to construct for this available flow. For that, you need to find the maximum between the ordinate, maximum ordinate between the AB line and the mass curve. So suppose if this is the point, maximum ordinate you are identifying means, and the y-axis quantity of this line, this means difference between this point and this point, you can calculate, and that is the day second meter unit quantity, and which will decide the capacity of the reservoir. For this case, if you draw in your own notebook, possibly you will get around 55,000 day second meter, right? And these are the two data you can get out of this. And one more thing you need to keep in your mind, out of the slope you are getting the flow rate. Suppose if the flow rate at which water is drawn is higher than the original slope what you arrived here, yes, it means that the reservoir level goes down. If you are decreasing the flow rate, your reservoir level increases. That is the meaning of that, right? So please hope you understood the mass curve. So now my expectation is, if I gave a data for the preliminary data for the mass curve, you can able to find what is the reservoir capacity and what is the flow rate you can expect, you can find. So hope you discuss the remaining thing in the classroom. Now we will discuss about the site selection for the hydroelectric power plants, right? So now the, with respect to the investigation of the site, the three prime thing you need to identify: the dam should be very close to the turbine, and you need a maximum voltage at the higher height altitude, and you need to find the place for the turbine, that means such that the shortest length of conduct should be arranged. The conduct is nothing but a channel which conducts water from the reservoir to the turbine. So imagine there is a pipeline arrangement between the reservoir and the turbine, right? And you need to discuss the remaining few things. Since this video will end by the 15th minute, so thanks in advance for listening. So you need to identify the largest catchment area at the higher height. You need to do the topographical mapping, that means you need to do a surveying of the land where you are expecting the your hydroelectric power plant project. And similarly, you need to do the geological studies, that means you need to do the resistivity of this, study the resistivity of the earth, and also you need to study the seismic aspects of the earth, all those things, and similarly you need to